My favorite rendition of Santa Claus is Coming to Town by the young Michael Jackson.
Well, if you guys are sitting out there this Sunday evening.
And the Jackson 5.
And the Jackson 5.
If everybody's sitting out there this Sunday evening and you have kids around, go to SantaSaysHello.com.
Oh, that's very good, Jim.
Go to SantaSaysHello.com. You're going to be able to talk to Santa.
Our friend MC Antle was on the show, and
they can maybe schedule an appointment because I'm sure he's very busy, but
I'm sure that's true.
They probably can.
SantaSaysHello.com.
SantaSaysHello.com.
She said it different than I did. Okay, but we're going to talk about IRS stuff because even Christmas doesn't stop the IRS. Let's do the question.
And now, here's that man with a head just Know-it-all.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Know-it-all, the segment where Attorney Stephen Leahy answers all those questions burning deep inside, such as, have you ever received coal in your stocking?
The answer is yes.
And do you enjoy fruitcake as a dessert?
I just had a conversation with somebody about it.
I've heard
if you have a really well-made one, it can be delicious.
Well, why would they be so popular and everywhere if they were so bad?
Right.
But I was
there's got to be some.
I was just watching a cooking show,
though.
And they put that. Oh, and Chopped. They put it in Chopped. They had a tough time.
And they had to make something out of it.
Yeah, so it was. It's kind of interesting to watch. I watched Chopped. Even my wife always says,
"I watch it too." Yeah,
why do you watch Chopped? You don't cook.
What about Jim? Do you watch Chopped?
No.
Do you chop? Okay, so what
do I cook? Yes.
I've talked about this on the show before, but I'm going to talk about it again because it's important. And I've had three people in the last 3 weeks call me about governmental agencies.
That's
contacting
one person
them.
Each week. The yeah. math checks out.
Oh, I didn't. I wouldn't have put that together, Jim. But that's true because I don't think it was all. It probably was 1-3 weeks ago, and then.
Come on. Okay.
So, but this
you're
is what,
stalling.
No, I'm not stalling. What I'm telling you is that these I get the same call. Right, that one I got a call from the IRS and she said, I'm making a visit out to your she called it a field visit. I'm going to make a field visit out to your client. Okay, so you please call me right away.
Excuse me?
And that's what I said, excuse me? And I called her right away and said, no, I don't think you're going to make a field visit out to my client's house. I said, why do you want to go out there? Well, they owe a lot of money, and so I want to look at their possessions and see what they own, what kind of property they have.
We're done talking.
So we could, I said, no, I don't think so. I don't think we're going to let you go out there.
I don't think that's going to work for
And it just doesn't make any sense, right? That if the IRS is it's knocking on your door, that's the IRS.
Nobody
calling.
Can hear that.
They can hear a little bit. If they're knocking on your door and they're asking you for questions, tell them. This is what I want you to tell them. I have an attorney. Okay, his name is Stephen Leahy, and his number is 312-664-6649. He's asked me not to talk to you without him present. Please call him.
The IRS says, when we knock on your door, we want money from you.
Very good. That's Christy from...
Yes, from Three's Company.
That's right. Okay, so now the second time I had it happened, I got a call from my client in panic because a criminal investigator from the IRS knocked on her door and asking her questions. She wasn't home, and they called her and said, we want you to come down and talk to us. We invite you to come down our office and answer a couple of questions. And she said, well, don't I have an attorney? And the thing was, is that I was her attorney a couple of years ago, and my power of attorney didn't go to the tax year that they were after, so they could call her directly. And they did. And she contacted me again in panic and near tears. Please, what am I supposed to do? I said, give me the guy's number. I sent her a new power of attorney, and I advanced the years, and I called the guy, and I sent him my power of attorney. He said, now contact me. Don't ever contact her again. And he said, well, it might help her if she came down and answered questions.
Oh, what a...
And here's my answer to him. I said, I can think of 1,001 reasons why she shouldn't come down and talk to you. And that 1,001 refers to section 1,001 in the code that Martha Stewart went to jail for under Section 1001. And so that, and he understood what I was saying, that I was not going to allow him to question my client without a grand jury indictment.
You have a guy on your side, you Oakland tax.
And that's what she said. I'm so happy I had you on my side. And then the third, was that the second one I was talking about? The third one, again, was the IRS. Actually was not the IRS. It was the SEC calling. And the SEC, same thing.
Southeastern Conference?
The Securities Exchange Commission.
I understand.
And they're calling him about some, and there were some IRS issues there. And the same thing, he called me, what do I do?
Anyway, I hope that answers your question.
Thank you, Mr. Know-It-All.
That's right. Thank you, Mr. Know-It-All. We can go into this.
I was cut short.
You know what? But we can go into this so much, but we're going to talk a little bit about it on our WatchTalkRadio.com. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, WatchTalkRadio.com. Every Friday you're going to be able to watch live our podcast, and you're going to see behind the scenes of what's going on. Remember, Open Tax Resolution does sponsor the show. 312-664-6649 to visit ChicagoTaxTeam.com or WatchTalkRadio.com. Ladies and gentlemen, Merry Christmas.
I love the music.
Stay tuned and come on back here on AM 560.
The Answer.